Hi everyone, here's Stella and me. We're going to do a review on Model 1's Acryl Gel Thermal Changing. It's 03, number 03. And I already did the filing and prep work. Wasn't a very good job, but I had trouble with it. Here's my poly gel brush. It's not in very good condition, and as you'll see, I do have trouble with it. You will need some alcohol for this, as to wipe out or push out the poly gel as your slip solution. That's what I was meaning to say. Excuse me, this, I'm not very good at talking on a voiceover. And the color is natural pink white. So here we go. This is how I do my poly gel. Some people do it differently. And I will be speeding up this video, as I did have trouble with pulling out the poly gel. Not because of the poly gel, it was because of my brush. So here we go. I'll come back in probably around the first nail, because as you'll see, I really had trouble with this brush, as you could already tell. It was very, very horrible. And like I said, it wasn't the poly gel's fault. It was my brush's fault. And needless to say, this brush did go in the trash. And we are getting a new brush. So, I'll let you watch and then I will be back. Now, let me say, you do have to make sure that you keep your brush wet at all times. Otherwise, as you will see during some of this, it will start sticking to the brush if you don't. So, make sure you do keep a damp brush at all times so the poly gel does not stick to the brush, and you're able to maneuver the poly gel at all times. And as you can see, I didn't realize that my alcohol had some glitter in it, and you'll see little specks of glitter, but I was able to file that off in the end. But even with the bad brush, you could see it's very easily able to be moved around, and I just had a very bad brush. And as you can see, it's coming out of the tube pink. That's because it's cold in the tube. So when it's cold, it's pink, and when it gets warm, it turns white. look at that bad brush, bad brush, bad brush. Holy smokes, watching this from this angle, it is just horrible. I really need a new brush. I can't believe I'm even gonna let you guys watch this. Wow. I think sometimes people should video themselves doing stuff and then watch themselves. It is just totally amazing. Stella and Gigi told me that I need to get videos out, and this is not the type of video I really want to be putting out there, but I'm gonna put this out there because, you know, whether it's good, whether it's bad, you know, you gotta start somewhere. And honestly, I really do good work, but this brush has really gotta go. And they say you could do good work with anything that you use, and it's true, but man, this brush, I don't think the end result came out half bad, you know, after the finished filing. But between the nail tips and this brush, I really had a hard time. And I'm still gonna put this video out there just to show how nice this poly gel is. And I'll go from there, you know, nothing more I can do. And hopefully people will keep watching, subscribe to my channel, and see the good work that I can do. And hopefully I can find better tips to go with Stella, because I am having a hard time finding decent tips to go with her. It seems like, you know, I have tips that are, you know, her ring finger seems to stick up, and tips that don't fit, and I'm just having a hard time with her and her tips. These ones didn't want to really fit. I had to file them to fit, and it was just pretty horrible. So hopefully I can find a solution to her, because I really do, you know, love using her. And then I ordered tips, stiletto tips, to go with her, and I got them in the mail today, and they ended up being some short almond tips. I don't know what these people thought, you know, by sending them. So Of course I'm sending them back, because even the size three I had to put in her pinky nail. No, that, you know, it just was unacceptable. So hopefully we get everything together here. And as you can see, this nail really, really, by this time, the brush was really, really being horrible with me. And I was having a very, very hard time. It seemed like no matter how much I tried to maneuver it, I played with it, it just, how wet the brush was, it just wanted to stick to the brush. And you could see how frayed the brush ends were. It just, this brush just was horrible at this point in time. It just kept screaming, "Retire me, retire me." I actually almost wanted to cry at this point. I wanted to say no video, no nothing, let's just quit this. But I couldn't do that. I promised Gigi I'd put out a video. And I thought no matter how horrible this brush was being, I was gonna get this done. So as we all know, this nail is going to take a lot of filing. And then we go to touch it. We go to touch it. And we say, no more touching. We're just going to nuke this nail and let it be. And then during this time that we are nuking this nail, we happen to look over at our brushes. And lo and behold, what do we see? But a brush that we might be able to use. That we should have probably used 4 nails ago. So this nail went a little smoother. Well, a whole lot smoother. So until I order another brush, I think this one is going to be the one that I use. I probably won't be doing no more poly gel nails until I order another brush. And as you can see now, how nice and smoothly this poly gel actually does lay out and smooth out with a brush that actually works. I wish I would have used this brush for everyone during the last four nails. And I'm sorry. And I'm sorry my hand's actually in the way. I will have a better camera view. The next time. Just keep my hand out of the way. I just got so excited that this was working. Sorry about that. I guess I forgot to shut my notifications off. See how nice and beautiful that it's maneuvering, and how smooth it's bringing down the poly gel. And now this is how a brush is supposed to work. And I didn't realize it at the time, but I did get that nail a little crooked by the way I was looking at it. And then I will be finished filing off camera. Hi, back after finished filing. This was the end result of the finished filing. Not the greatest, but you know. So we're going to use our Model 1's top and base coat for the finished effects. They actually do have a pretty good top and base coat. I really like them. So I'm going to start with the base coat, and I will speed this up because we all know how to apply base coat, at least I hope we do, and I'll come back after we get done with the base coat. I'm just going to be applying some gems to these nails so we get the full effect of the poly gel thermal effects get a little icky on there. Okay, I'll be back. Okay, I am gonna be using the Mia Secret gel resin for the gems on these nails. And as you can see on the side of this thumbnail, I did kind of miss some of it with the poly gel. So we're just gonna go down the side of the one nail with the gems to kind of like hide that and maybe try to even out this nail a little bit. And if I can, I'll try to find a link to where I got these gems. I got these a real long time ago. I'm not sure if I got these on Amazon, but I'll try to find the link to where I got these gems at. I couldn't believe the one nail that I got the brush to actually work properly, and I missed the whole side of the nail. And then it looks like I added a little too much of the gel resin. You have to watch out when adding the gel resin that you don't add too much, but you don't want to add too little, because then it'll set up too fast on you, and then you're stuck wherever you put that gem. You ain't gonna be able to move it. Okay, now we're gonna move on to the pointer finger. And here we're just gonna go up and add a couple along the cuticle area. Gonna try to center that one. Then I think I add only two stones one on each side. Couldn't get that one off the And then this nail, the middle nail, we're going to do a diagonal. And I'm going to alternate the clear stone and the light pink stone. I don't know if it's showing up, if it's going to show up for you as the light pink stones. Because they're very light pink. And here I think I speed it up a little bit because otherwise this video is going to be very, very long. That stone was a little bit big. And then here we just add, I think, one middle stone and two stones on the outer sides. And then on the pinky, we're just going to do some of the little stones. I had to go get a little, another little stone. And as you can see, I did add a little too much of the gel, the resin, because they start. Now we're going to go in with the Mia Secret Activator. That helps the gel set a little bit faster. Now we're going to go in with our top coat. Now with the top coat, you want to go all the way up to where your gems are to seal in your gems. but you don't want to cover your gems because you'll take away the shine. And then after you get done, you want to make sure that you seal your ends. And you're going to put them in the UV lamp for 1 minute. And now, we're going to put some, you see how white they are, they're because they've been heated. We're going to do a test on these. And I'm going to get some water. And we're going to put some water on the ends of them. And see how the thermo reaction works. As you can see, the thumb and the pointer finger is already turning pink on the ends. And see, at my view, it really wasn't looking like it was turning pink. So, I went and got some ice and put ice in the water. Not realizing that it was really turning pink already. So we made it a little colder. And you could see the pink reaction there and how white it was up by, and I don't know why, because Stella really wasn't warm, but you could see how pink it was turning. It didn't seem to look that pink though for me. But the thermal gel looks really nice. And it works really good. I even put an ice cube on it. Now, we're going to go ahead and we're going to take the lamp and we're going to heat her up. And we're going to see the reaction there. Now, mind you, this lamp is just a mini lamp, so it heated up, but I think her tips stayed a little bit pink, so it really didn't get her tips very well. I guess it was the angle that I had the lamp at. So as you could see, you know, it got some of it, but it really didn't get like all of it. And I'm sure on a real hand, it's gonna get a lot more because we're more warm-blooded than Stella, obviously. At least I hope we are. Okay, now I'm going to bring you in for a closer view. It's a little blurry at first. There we go. There you can see the pink stones. But this is the end result of the thermal gel. And I hope you liked my video. If you did, please subscribe. Hit that bell if you want to see future videos. And me and Stella will be back, and I'll be back alone. At times, by myself without Stella. And believe it or not, I really do a better job. And hopefully we get our stuff figured out with Stella. And we hope to see you guys all soon. Say bye, Stella. Bye, guys.